We also heard news today from a vaccine trial sponsored in part by NIAID. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about what we're learning on the vaccine front.
So there's a number of different approaches to HIV vaccines moving forward. One is the 702 trial, which is a follow-on of RV144. Another somewhat distinct one uses a technology called a mosaic. And a mosaic is still an idea that is not yet proven in humans, but it has been demonstrated to work reasonably well in non-human primates. That is, can you make, it is a computer-designed virus that uses all the different sequences to build, in many ways, the ideal genetic construction so that the idea is then the body can digest this idealized virus and make more responses against the HIV.
So the sequences are the sequences of HIV around the world occur?
Yes. It's globally designed with the intent to be globally designed. What we are testing, however, is that construct in the context of a clade C epidemic here in sub-Saharan Africa.
So clade C is the
localized HIV that is most prevalent here in Africa.
And there are different ones in
North America, it's called B, and other places it's called AE, and it has to do with the degree of sequence difference. So think about your hand. This would be, your thumb would be C, B would be over here, AE would be here. But all of these, the spacing between your fingers would represent the degree of diversity or difference between each of the fingers. All fingers are similar, but they're all unique. I hope that helps people understand the analogy here. But ultimately, if you make one, if they were all could be used as the same, then a response against this would then work over here.
And so this virus this vaccine technology
uses all five.
Got it.
Produce it to one, where then it'd be a fist that would kill HIV.
Hopefully.
That's the hypothesis.
Great.
So that study's moving forward.
What
we are hearing today is the results indicate that we are close to finalizing a design for this vaccine that'll involve a series of four shots. And then there's one additional study that is ongoing that we are working with Janssen on that will then determine what the impact of one additional component on this vaccine, and then we'll be ready to start.
Okay. So what should people keep in mind for the next few years for HIV vaccine research? A lot of folks want to know, when am I going to be able to get a vaccine for HIV?
I think that's an important question, is we do need to manage people's expectations, but also keep the field and the interested population informed that these studies are ongoing. Vaccine research is different than therapeutics research. You can take a drug and immediately see an effect within a couple of weeks of whether the drug is going to work or not. With a vaccine, you have to create an immune response, you have to wait, and then wait. So these things take time. Within 3 years, most likely we'll have a readout on these different vaccines.
So today we saw some early data. We'll see more in the coming months, and then
we may move forward into a significantly larger trial, which we would call a test of concept study. And then from there, depending on what we see, move forward or regroup and redesign.
And you mentioned earlier that we have HVTN-702, which is a large vaccine efficacy trial that we launched on World AIDS Day in South Africa last year. Why do we need two large vaccine trials that might be in the field?
Well, that's a really important question. They're asking two different questions. The 702 trial, it's a follow-up on a study called RV144, which was the first vaccine trial to ever show efficacy, albeit modest efficacy, in an at-risk population, and it was done in Thailand. And what we were able to do by analyzing the results of the specimens from the people in RV144 is develop concepts of why that vaccine worked. We then went back and thought about and redesigned, tweaked the constructs so we could see if we could improve upon the RV144 construct. So in many ways, this is a hypothesis testing rather than a hypothesis generating concept. So if 702 works, we will have validated what we saw in RV144 and then allow us to further build to something maybe better in the future. In the case of what we're doing with Janssen, it's a brand new concept. And so in that sense, it's good for the field not to have all your eggs in one basket, given the fact that there's no guarantees in life. And if you think about the failures we had on the drug side for years before we got to combination antiretroviral therapy, we're going to need two or more vaccine studies to get us to a point where we have the ultimate goal of a safe, effective, and durable HIV vaccine for the globe.